Ethiopia did not possess the state of the art of military equipment at the time. It was His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie who enabled the country to be a military might in the Horn of Africa. This was a historical achievement that guaranteed the national sovereignty and freedom of Ethiopia, which was a prerequisite for all other development activities. One of the historic achievements of His Majesty is his efforts to bring African leaders together to lay the foundations of the Organization of African Unity. Ethiopia, as a gesture of the country's dedication for the unity and integrity of African states, provided the accommodating edifices of the OAU and the ECA. His diplomatic ability gained the personal friendship of African leaders, the likes of Gamal Abdel Nasser of Egypt, Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana, Jomo Kenyatta of Kenya, Julius Nyerere of Tanzania, and others. His Majesty had also visited world figures, the likes of Queen Elizabeth and other heads of state. His Majesty was one of the few elderly political leaders of the world and had enjoyed world acclaim during most of his life in office. A military junta comprising members of nominated from the ground forces, the air force, the police and the territorial army took over power of leadership by force and led the country to untold chaos. The Derg, as the military junta called itself, ousted the emperor from power. A squad of military personnel, escorted by reporters, was sent to the palace to read out the end of his reign to him. He was driven in a small Volkswagen sedan to the premises of the 4th Division, where he was imprisoned. Other government officials, including the former Prime Minister Zahafi Tezaza Kluda Abtol, were also kept behind bars, letter to be inhumanly gunned down without being tried and convicted for any crime they may have committed. The Emperor was later moved to the Grand Palace and kept in a solitary confinement near the headquarters of the Derg.
ማታ ራት ካበላኋቸው በኋላ ወደ መኝታ ቤታቸው ሲገቡ አንተን ወደ ሌላ ክፍል ልንወስድ ነው አሉኝ። ዘቦች እኔ ልጃሜ ሳልነግር
On the night of the 20th Nahase, 1967, that is August 28, 1975, the security guards told me they want to see me alone after serving His Majesty his supper before he retired to bed. I told them I could not leave him alone without his consent. They let me in to inform him. He told me to oblige. I took leave of him and joined them half-heartedly. As I was leaving the room, I looked back and saw him near the window facing Kidana Mihrat Church. He looked up and said, "O Ethiopia, have we wronged you?" He then wept and shed his tears. He turned off the light and sat composed in a state of desolation. I was deeply touched when I left. They pushed me out and locked me in the guardhouse. The next morning, I was ordered to serve breakfast. As I opened the door, I was stunned and shocked of what I saw. I fell unconscious. I saw His Majesty wrapped in a blanket and some bandages. He was frozen and still and placed in a sitting position. The room was choking from the smell of anesthetic ether. Late in the morning, Mengistu Haile Mariam, accompanied by Atnapu Abate, came and went to see the emperor and left the room probably after confirming the death of His Majesty. This room here was Mengistu Haile Mariam's office. The other one belonged to Mengistu Gemmechu, beneath which His Majesty was buried. The staircase you see here was not here before. I must admit certain changes have taken place while I was in prison.
It can't be said that it is genocide and massacre that Erg has committed. People were killed and buried in mass in secret. Times have changed now and the atrocious crimes are unfolding. Graves are dug and human remains are being unearthed.
Members and friends of the royal family and all present to pay their due respect wept at the saddening sight.